Tuesday's protesters say that it is their democratic right to speak out on what is happening in their country. The men feel that Mr. Le Corbusier's statements were threatening. However, they believe that they have done nothing wrong.
So if I said that the Minister for Health only saying the hospital will be opening, and it's not opening, what I have said that's wrong, that affecting the government, and in my opinion, Mr. Le Corbusier has to respect people's democratic rights. And if I have to do it again, I am saying it to the government of St. Lucia on the behalf of the people of St. Lucia. If I have to protest to free my country, I will do it again.
Leone says he was not paid or asked to do what he did by anyone, especially the UWP's political leader, Alan Chastney. He says that he came to protest on his own free will, given his frustration with the government.
I don't know if I'm a threat to the St. Lucia Labour Party. I have never insulted anybody. And I am telling Mr. Le Corbusier, do not threaten St. Lucia because this is a democracy.
One protester says this is not his first time participating in a demonstration of this nature.
In 1979, when we came here in the Constitution Park and John Compton was going to Parliament, and we were saying, hey, hey, Mija Black, Compton is a devil, and all kind of things like that. It was good to do it for Labour. But now Labour is in office and things is going wrong. We are speaking out. It is bad that Philippe Le Corbusier want to pass all kind of laws on us.
The men say they will continue to speak their mind as long as they live in a democratic country. For the DBS News, I am Jenna Anne Gaston.